Coming up on this edition of the FGCU Sports Report, we take a look at the bittersweet end to an amazing season of women's basketball. We visit with a couple of swimming and diving sisters, and men's golf coach Brent Jensen and women's golf coach Sarah True stop by in the coach's corner. All that and more in this edition of the FGCU Sports Report.
The FGCU Sports Report is made possible by Mutual of Omaha Bank, matching the right financial service to the right customer at the right time. Mutual of Omaha Bank, your bank every step of the way. And employee-owned Home Tech, serving Southwest Florida for 30 years with service agreements on air conditioning and all major appliances. And by the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery, dedicated to your good health always.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health always.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
Hello, Eagles fans. I'm your host, Tom James, and welcome to another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. Well, it seems that every season that they take to the court, the FGCU women's basketball team is making history and setting records, and this year was no exception. Sports reporter Josh Siegel takes a look at how the Lady Eagles felt about making it to the NCAA tournament.
4 years ago, FGCU women's basketball coach Carl Smesko offered Kelsey Jacobson the chance to realize a childhood dream, with a caveat. The three-year starting guard, who was second in career three-point makes among active players, would play Division I, but she would only have one shot at making it to the NCAA tournament.
Growing up, I just wanted to play Division I basketball, and he emphasized the point that we'd still be competing at the Division I level. We'd be in a conference, an opportunity to win the conference tournament, you know, and we have the opportunity to go to WNIT every year. But I think, you know, it's a dream to go NCAA tournament, and even if it is just that one shot, I mean, it was kind of a big deal.
It wasn't guaranteed, but Jacobson saw the shot coming, even if no one else did.
It was a lot of learning. You know, everybody was just kind of starting to understand the program. We weren't well known. Back home, people would ask me where I went to school, and then they would be like, FC, you know, they never got it. But the support here was, you know, incredible. So I think even back then, like, you could tell something special was going to happen in this program.
In its first season of eligibility, FGCU became the first ASUN team to go 18-0 in conference play and storm to the ASUN tournament title. The Lady Eagles also hovered outside top 25 polls before falling to St. Bonaventure in the first round of the NCAA tournament. Jacobson says the NCAA tournament weight drove the Eagles, even as they tried to block it out.
There was definitely a longing for it. Every year, you know, we just were one year closer to it. But I don't know. I think honestly, just we were really focused every season on the individual season. We didn't really look too far ahead. You know, once this year came, it was like, okay, now we can get excited about it. And I think that's when it really hit us.
More than anything, Jacobson cherishes FGCU's ASUN tournament run in Macon, Georgia, where Eagles fans flocked to watch its team win three games in the title by a combined score of 222-155 and earn an NCAA tournament berth.
It was absolutely incredible. It was so unexpected to see how many people were even at the ASUN conference tournament, and then just every game was exciting, and it was nerve-wracking, and the adrenaline and the intensity, it was just so much fun. And then to win it and see everybody go crazy, I mean, President Bradshaw was thrilled. I mean, that means a lot right there.
After the Eagles clinched a spot in the NCAA tournament, they waited some more. On March 12th at the NCAA selection show party at Alico Arena, FGCU and hundreds of its fans nervously watched a live ESPN telecast find out its seeding, foe, and site. Courtney Cheehill, a do-it-all, all-A-Sun guard who came in with Jacobson 4 years ago, traded laughs with tears before her first NCAA tournament game.
Besides being very nervous, it's extremely exciting. After being here for 4 years and looking forward to this moment since I was a little kid and only knowing that I had one chance at it, I really can't put into words how exciting it is and how proud I am of my team right now.
The wait that night couldn't compare to the last 4 years, before Smesco promised little more than a dream.
I think it was the confidence that I had in coach and the confidence that I had in the players that came to school here. I knew it was a great program and I knew there was a great chance that we were going to make it to the NCAA tournament, and I kind of just put all my hope and faith into that. The WNIT has helped kind of ease the wait, but it's been a long 3 years, 4 years waiting to get to this point.
Sophomore forward Sarah Hansen won't go into details about the first round NCAA tournament loss, where 500 or so Eagle fans traveled to Tallahassee to watch the 12th-seeded Eagles hold an 11-point second-half lead against number 5 St. Bonaventure before falling. Hansen fared well. She led FGCU with 15 points and a game-high 11 rebounds.
I think it's still kind of, you know, raw, so nobody really wants to talk about it, but we all know that it was a great season, and yeah, it didn't necessarily end how we wanted it to end, but I mean, all in all, we had an awesome season. We went 29-3. Like, that's something to be proud of. Like, we won. We were undefeated in conference. That's not something that every team does.
Thanks, Josh. And as always, you can find the latest news, scores, and highlights for all of FGCU sports at FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. Men's golf coach Brent Jensen on the FGCU Sports Report. Great to have you here, partner.
Thank you, Tom.
You're in your second season, coming down at 18, if you will, in the spring. What's this year been like for you and the team?
It's been a little bit of a roller coaster. We had we started off real strong in the fall. You know, we went in 4 out of 5 tournaments in the fall. Was a great job and great plan by our guys. And you know, we had a little break during the off season and came back in the spring and we struggled a little bit early. And you know, we've managed to put good rounds here and there together, but we haven't been able to put a tournament together yet. So we're still kind of working towards that.
It's a big topic of conversation, obviously, with every coach at FGCU, being postseason eligible finally.
Right.
How does that change the mindset for you and for the players as well?
I don't think it changes our mindset, really. Our goal every year is to win our conference championship. And we haven't been postseason eligible, but we've been one of the few teams that have been allowed to play in their conference championship. So that's always been one of our goals. And if we take care of that goal, then the postseason stuff comes automatically.
Coming up in April, the A-Sun Championships. What's the confidence level right now of this team heading in?
I think we have a great deal of confidence. Our spring season hasn't been that great, but you know, we've played a lot of good rounds. And 4 out of our last 6 rounds have been under par. So I think we have a lot of confidence, you know, going into our conference tournament.
If it came to it, is an at-large bid to the NCAAs realistic for you guys?
I don't think so at this point.
Okay.
We don't have any other tournaments to play in, so it's all about conference. If we win our conference tournament, we get to go. If we don't, it'll be tough.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dr. Jim Suddy, who was the director of golf operations for FGCU and the first coach ever for mm-hmm. the Eagles, stepped down in November. I know he has meant a lot to you. Talk about his influence on you.
Yeah, Dr. Suddy's been a personal friend of mine. I started taking lessons from him when I was in high school at a really young age. So I've known Doc for a long time, and he's done great things for this golf program, and he's laid a great foundation for this program. And it's been quite easy to come in and, you know, help continue to grow the success of the golf program since, you know, he's been around.
I know that being the head coach, you also get a lot of leadership help from some of your upperclassmen,
mm-hmm.
And that's certainly a big help to you as a head coach. Talk about that a little bit, what that means to you.
Well, two of our best players in Brandon Penna and Alex Medinas are also seniors and in their last year, and they're our team captains. They're co-captains this year. So having their leadership on and off the golf course has meant a great deal to me and to the team. I don't have any assistants. It's just me. So to have those guys help out and keep everybody, you know, help me keep everybody on the same page helps out a lot.
What do they do specifically that adds to the leadership of the team?
They help me keep the guys on point at practice. Okay. You know, they're the ones that, you know, lead by example. They show up every day ready to work, and they're better this year about being more vocal about it too and keeping the guys on track. So I can't be everywhere at practice, you know, when there's guys in the short game area or driving range or putting green. It's nice to have those guys around to help push them.
Talking about your goals for the coming years at FGCU, is this a program that you can see in the future going toe-to-toe with the heavyweights in college golf?
Absolutely. I think for FGCU golf, it's only a matter of time. I'm hoping that our conference tournament goes well so we can make a big splash in our first year at the postseason. But I think, yeah, it's only a matter of time before we can compete on a regular basis with the top golf teams in the country.
We talked about some of the veterans on the team, but tell us a little bit about what the next crop of young FGCU golfers is going to look like, the ones that are now on the team and the mm-hmm. ones that may be coming in the future.
We have a freshman in Jack Hernandez who's won 2 weeks now, the A-Sun Golfer of the Week, which is a great honor with the teams and players that are in our conference. And next year we have three guys coming in. Two are local, one in Jake Sherwin, who's a local Naples boy, and same with Edward Figueroa. Edward is a senior. He'll be here next year with Jake, and he's won the Puerto Rico Junior AJGA tournament, and he'll be playing, you know, he played last 2 weeks ago in the Puerto Rico Open, which is the PGA Tour event, got an exemption into that. So he's a really good player and already has PGA Tour experience under his belt at
awesome.
18. So,
all right. We wish you the best of luck at the conference tournament coming up
thanks.
In April, and thanks for joining us on the show.
I appreciate it, Tom.
All right.
Thank you.
You bet. And if you're a fan of social media, you can always like the Sports Report on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. And you can watch your favorite episodes of the Sports Report 24/7 on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on your screen and enjoy.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Want more from your bank? We'll give you advice you can rely on, security you can trust. Personal or professional, whichever you like. Bankers here invest time with you to secure your financial future. Family investments, business credit, wealth management. More than a bank, we are family at Mutual of Omaha Bank. Your bank, every step of the way. Offices Naples, Marco Island, Fort Myers, Tampa.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
More than just teammates, they're also sisters. Danielle and Megan Butler from the swimming and diving team at FGCU. Great having you guys here on the Sports Report.
Thank you. Thank you.
Danielle, I'll start with you since you're the big sister, and you're the swimmer of the two. Conference mm-hmm. champions once again. What's it been like to be able to share that with your sister?
Oh, it's been fantastic. Even though it's been, you know, for only one semester that we were able to compete together, it was really, really special.
Megan, you're the diver of the two, and you're a junior and a transfer from Florida Atlantic. What made you decide to join Danielle here at FGCU?
I just wanted to be a part of the great program they have over here, and I've been lucky enough to have such success with them, so I'm really glad I made the move.
Now, I know you guys always hear about the sibling rivalry thing. Is that the case, though, with you guys?
Absolutely not.
No.
Yeah, we have two separate events, and we know we need to work as one in order to win championships like we did.
Yeah, now being on the same team, we share the same goals, so no rivalry here.
Well, what made you guys lean towards your specific sports with you and diving with you?
Well, we definitely have similar stories by starting our sport, you know, very later in life, as maybe you could say, at 16. And to be competing at a up-and-coming school in Division I has been fantastic. So,
yeah.
How about you?
I had a background in gymnastics, and then like Danielle started swimming her junior year of high school, I started diving because she convinced me to join the swimming and diving team back then. So that's how I got involved in it.
Okay. Well, you guys are from Southern New York, and Danielle, what made you initially choose FGCU? Because you were a transfer from St. Bonaventure.
Correct. I initially chose St. Bonaventure because, you know, starting swimming at 16, I didn't have the resume, you know, that maybe other swimmers, you know, looking to enter Division I had. So I chose them, and it was okay for a year, but then I found out about this program, and I just wanted to become a part of the FGCU family. They were so up and coming, and we've achieved such great success over these past 3 years.
Well, glad to have you here. For a high school swimmer or diver out there who's considering a college, why would you recommend that they choose FGCU? I'll start with you.
I mean, most importantly, the program, the type of bond that we have with our team, I don't think can be recreated anywhere else. We definitely, you know, look for girls who would just enhance the program. And if you want a really big family feel, then this is the place to choose.
Especially for you.
Absolutely.
Megan, why have you? What have you enjoyed so far about FGCU?
Well, coming from a transfer, I would definitely say choose FGCU first. And yeah, my reason for coming here was to be part of the family, and just in general, they're running a really great athletics program where, you know, the athletic director knows your name, and just the staff has been so great, and to be a part of a team that works so hard and accomplishes so much has been really great for me.
Let me ask you about you guys' families, because New York is quite a ways from Southwest Florida. Do they get a chance to come and watch you guys at your meets?
Yes, absolutely. I think our dad is known on the team as being the ultimate dad that will come and surprise us.
Okay.
And so we recently surprised them, my parents, this weekend for their anniversary. So it was a great role reversal, and we're just so happy that they would be able to come down and, you know, now watch the both of us on the same team.
Yeah, right. And it was great to share at conference championships our back-to-back wins and to have our parents there. So that was really special for us.
Must have been exciting. Well, congratulations, you guys, on all your success. And Danielle and Megan Butler, great to have you on the Sports Report.
Thank you so much.
And to find out more about the Eagles' fantastic swimming and diving team and all of FGCU sports, go to FGCUathletics.com, the official site of the FGCU Eagles. It's True, Sarah True, women's golf coach at FGCU, joining us on the Sports Report. Great having you here
with us. Thank you. I appreciate it. Good to be here.
You're coming down the back nine of your first season as a coach here with the Blue and Green. Talk about what it's been like.
It's definitely been a little bit of a roller coaster of a season. The girls trying to adjust to me and my coaching philosophy, and we've had some injuries, so we're actually down to four players right now and having to count every score when we play in a tournament. But I'll give them credit. I mean, they handle the pressure really well. You know, we've actually put up some good rounds, but it's just hard to put that all together when you're having to count every single score. We've got one more tournament coming up and then conference, so we're really excited, and I still think we can play well. We just have to have everybody firing on all cylinders at the same time.
You were an assistant with the Kansas Jayhawks for five years, coming from the Big 12 conference to the smaller A-Sun. What are some of the differences?
You know, I just think sometimes the level of competition, and I think definitely with our conference that's improving. We've got some great coaches. You know, Kennesaw State is a fine team. East Tennessee State, they're doing well this year. So you can see the level of competition really rising. But definitely in the Big 12, you know, you've got Texas, Oklahoma State, and it's tough to compete with them, especially with the warm weather. You're up in Kansas, it's a little bit cold. But I'm loving it here. It's a great community. Everybody's behind us, and it's nice to be here.
What made you choose FGCU?
I think a lot of it is the location.
Yeah.
In Kansas, it's hard to recruit kids because 4 months out of the year, you're buried under snow. Here you can play 365 days a year, and yeah, again, the community, the facilities are just absolutely unbelievable. You couldn't ask for much more.
Well, I was going to ask you, what's the difference between the golf culture in Southwest Florida and where you come from, sort of in America's heartland? What's got to be some differences?
Well, definitely the level of talent with junior players. There's so many incredible players here, and you know, even some of the members of the community that play. There's 122, 125 golf courses in the area, so we definitely get a lot more backing. A lot more use of facilities, and it's a much easier sell too.
You're known as a tireless recruiter. What are some of the ways that you do sell FGCU to high school kids?
Actually, it's pretty easy. I think it sells itself. Like I said, our facilities, the courses we get to use, we jump around to a different course each week. We get to play out at Miramar, West Bay, Plantation, Grandeza. That's one of the first trips I make is taking those kids out to the golf courses and letting them see what they get to play.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen a lot of facilities around the country, and there's not many teams that get to play at the types of courses we do.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of talent in your own backyard here as well.
Absolutely. And, you know, with having in-state tuition, again, it's bright futures. It's a really easy sell. I usually don't have to do too much work.
Talk about the goals maybe that you've laid out for the program moving forward in the coming years.
Well, I'm extremely competitive, and I know this team is too. So my personal goals for us and the team, I want to win conference. I tell them that, you know, every tournament we go to, we want to win. We want to have that mindset that we're going to walk away with the hardware at the end of the day. So, you know, just to be able to keep pounding that into their heads, and you know, just saying, okay, we need to prepare ourselves, treat every practice like a tournament, so we can take that, and when we do go to tournaments, we're not nervous, we feel very comfortable. But in the end, I want to win conference, I want to get to regionals, nationals. It just might take a couple years.
Now, you've inherited some quality upperclassmen, or upperclass women, if you will, but you've also got some talented freshmen and some good players coming in the future.
Definitely. We've got three freshmen right now that were actually quite young. We've only got one senior, one junior, one sophomore, and three freshmen. Mm-hmm. So we're really developing the freshman squad. And then, you know, we've got Brianna, who's just been an incredible leader. She's been injured this whole year, so I think she's been able to learn a lot just watching golf and getting a little different idea from the spectator side and just how to play, how to manage your game. And she's been a great help. You know, she's an incredible leader, and I think she's really helped develop those freshmen, and she's going to be around another couple years, so I'm really looking forward to that.
Now, you played golf at Arkansas, where you were a double major in criminal justice and sociology, so I'm guessing you're not going to put up with any slacking in the classroom from your players.
Absolutely not, but you know what? I mean, it's pretty easy. They take care of their business. For the most part, golfers are pretty good student athletes, and we actually won the highest individual sport team GPA last semester. So they know my expectations. Basically, go to class, do what is expected, and I kind of dangle study hall in front of their face too. I said, if you want to get out of study hall, you have to have at least a 3.0.
Great to have you with us.
Thank
Sarah
you. I
True.
Appreciate
Thanks
it.
For joining us.
Thank you.
And as always, you can find the Sports Report on both Facebook and Twitter, and catch your favorite past episodes of the Sports Report on YouTube. Just log on to the addresses on the screen and enjoy.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Do you need knee, hip, or shoulder replacement? Visit the Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, specializing in total joint replacement surgery. The doctors and staff will assist you in all aspects of your care, from preparing for surgery to your return to normal activities as soon as possible.
It's good professional staff. They just do their job very well, and I recommend it highly.
The Joint Academy at Lehigh Regional Medical Center, dedicated to your good health always.
No fuss, no muss. First call's on us. Today's repair, whether air conditioning or major appliance, is covered under your new service agreement.
Well, that's all the time we have for today's show, but we'll be back again next month with another edition of the FGCU Sports Report. I'm Tom James. Thanks for watching, and go Eagles!